clap is impressive.
I think that was during a big like goal, maybe empty net goal at some point in the season.
Big moment.
Big moment big in the moment. NHL season.
Big deal.
We've had some big moments. Yes, we had some big moments last night, actually.
Yes, we did.
As I'm segueing into the what's going on around the league. We're talking about two teams, right, that made a lot of moves that need to get in the playoffs that got big wins last night. So you're going to look at Columbus.
Okay.
Who, EJ, we talked about them.
It's hosting right now.
I know. I love it.
It's Get With It.
Yeah, that's right.
Columbus needed a W.
Very energized.
Columbus needed a W, and they're playing Jersey, right? And Colorado needed a W. And they played Detroit, but we're starting with Columbus, who last night got off to a quick 1-0 lead less than a minute in. But this is a team who, after making all these moves and getting Zingle and getting Duchesne and deciding, all right, we're going for it, well, they had lost a couple in a row. They're struggling, and they go into Jersey, and they had to grind out a win. That was the whole point, EJ. It wasn't going to be easy for them.
No, I mean, you can see the Devils really had the better of the play, 30 shots on goal in the game, and could have easily won it. Give credit to the Jackets. They did get a 2-1 victory in this one in the shootout, and their schedule, I'm looking ahead.
Yes.
I mean, home and home with the Penguins, at the Islanders, Boston, Carolina, Boston again, at Calgary, at Edmonton, but Edmonton just beat them. I mean, the funny thing about their schedule is, it's all these hard games. They finish the season the last day of the season, second of a back-to-back. Where do they finish? In Ottawa.
Wow.
Who they made the big deal with. So it will be funny to see if that game means something, how things unfold. But, they've got their hands full.
Imagine the Sens could play spoiler on the last
day. Oh, they would be loving that.
They would love that. That would be motivation.
Their old
enough.
Buddy, Matt Duchesne.
Yeah.
Welcome out of the playoffs.
Yeah. Could you imagine? If the Blue Jackets missed the playoffs, would you consider the deadline deals a disaster?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, that was put together to not only get in the playoffs, but get in there and win a couple rounds, possibly win the Stanley Cup. I mean, that's what they're thinking with these guys that, you know, Duchesne, Panarin, Bobrovsky, they could all be gone. And they have plans in place if that were to be the case. But I think that part of it is let's go out and see if we can get a Stanley Cup, get a couple rounds into the playoffs. Maybe these guys will come back. So that's one of those things where that's worst case scenarios. They don't get in. It's bad if they get in losing the first round, I think, let alone not getting in at all.
Yeah, you're right. I think if they were to miss the playoffs, it would be a pretty terrible situation. And I got to be around Yarmoe at the GM's meetings and talk to him about it. And, you know, the general manager can only do what's in front of him to try to do. And he made some bold moves. And I like him, and I stand by those moves, what I thought about it. And I thought it was the right thing to do. We'll see if it plays out and it works out in their favor. The Eastern Conference, he pointed this out, and it's really true. You may need 99 points to get in the playoffs this year in the Eastern Conference.
Wow.
I don't know if you've ever had to have
that's
if that was the line, 99 points. So it's going to be really tough for the Blue Jackets. I wish those guys well because there was some bold moves there. But, if they don't make it, it's not good. Let's face it. Not good.
96 points is the most without making it.
Wow.
So that's telling you something there.
Maybe something changes with how many three-point games. Yeah. Who knows?
Yeah.
Because that's wild.
If they're in the West, they're sitting in a playoff. They're sitting pretty.
Yeah, they're playing for home ice, probably.
Yeah, crazy.
I still say Yarmo's a G, though.
I loved it too.
You mentioned Colorado when you intro'd this topic, Whit. And Colorado is a team that, needs to rack up some Ws. They reunited that top line last night, and they end up walking away with 2 points.
Yeah, and this is another team who's, fighting for their playoff lives, playing against a team who's obviously not going to get in this year and is looking more at the draft. And it was a struggle, but I think that's a good thing. The same way it was a struggle for Columbus to get a win to get back on track, Colorado had to grind out. They had to tie a game up late. They had to win in overtime. They don't worry about the other point. Detroit doesn't need it. But for a team that needs a win to get home and battle back to get a win, sometimes it's not the 6-0 win that gets you going. It's just it's winning a hard game, even though it's not against the best team in the league. You look at their schedule coming up, too. It's a big win for them to try to figure out what to get going here. Because the beginning of the year, remember how good they were?
Yep.
Remember how good things were rolling? And they want to try to get back to that. Getting that top line together is certainly going to help.
And, in the game against Red Wings last evening, they were able to score with the goaltender out. Tyson Barry scored, and then McKinnon wins it in overtime. So it was a really big win for them. Their schedule, you compare it to Columbus has a very difficult schedule. The Avalanche, their strength of schedule as we stand now, it's their tied, I believe, for the eighth easiest schedule down the stretch. So that might help them, but you still got to win the games no matter who you play.
And that's the thing, too. You got to be careful that you don't overlook teams.
Exactly.
Like, we got the Sens on the schedule, easy dub. Yeah. And then you go in there and you're like down 2-0 in 5 minutes. You're like, what happened?
I'll be interested to see if they add Cale Makar down the stretch. That's been a big talk that when his college season ends, that he would leave college and then turn pro. He is a talented young defenseman. I'll be curious to see if that happens and if they put him right in the lineup. and to see how he could respond in what would be pressure games down the stretch.
That is one thing you've always said all season about the Avs, especially once they sort of fell off a little bit, was even if they don't make the postseason, they have a lot of talent coming in the next couple of years, and Cale Makar is certainly probably at the top of
that. And they may end up still with the number one pick overall in the draft because they own Ottawa's draft pick, as we've talked about many times.
And I'm sure Sens fans are so happy that you're reminding them of that.
I didn't make the deal.
Though. No, you
didn't.
Going to be fun to watch the Sens, or excuse me, the Avs, down the stretch to see what they can accomplish.